communication. Let us see characteristics of communication in this module. Objective of this session can be, at the end of this session, you will be able to illustrate characteristics of communication. Have a look at these characteristics of communication. Let us see these characteristics one by one. Communication is verbal and non-verbal. If we say verbal communication, what all comes to our mind? Verbal communication may be a speech, may be something written on the board, may be something given to us through handout or through books, maybe some articles on the net. But wherever language is used, verbal messages are used, can be verbal communication. There are many, many forms of non-verbal communication. Sender's gestures, sender's body language always play important role in communication along with the verbal communication. Photos, cartoons, diagrams, illustrations also help the communication to be effective. If we talk about a poster or a diagram, it may be a combination of verbal and non-verbal communication. When teacher displays a particular teaching aid or when learners are given some handbooks, there may be some verbal messages as well as non-verbal messages. Communication is dynamic. What do we mean by that? We already know that communication has many components. These components keep on changing always, and then the entire communication process becomes dynamic. The moment sender changes, role of sender changes, nature of sender changes, attitude of sender changes, communication process changes. Sometimes qualities of receiver changes. Then also the communication process gets affected. In messages, either medium may change or channel may change. Communication is a complex process, and with every change of component, it becomes dynamic. It changes with the context also. Communication is circular. Sender imparts message to the receiver and receiver gives feedback to the sender. Now again, sender gives another message or response to that feedback. Then the receiver again sends some message. This goes on and goes on, and finally no one can actually trace who is the sender and the receiver. Many a times all are senders, all are receivers. There is always continuous exchange of ideas, exchange of messages. You can see in this picture that the entire group is very interestingly working on something. They all must be working together, exchanging their ideas in a hurry to complete the task, and we cannot make out who is the sender of which message, when the message exchange started and where it's ending. This is how communication is circular. Communication is a complex process. Very simplified manner says that communication starts from sender and ends at receiver. But who is the sender and who is the receiver is a question. Human being always keeps on communicating, always keeps on exchanging messages. This example again is an example to tell us how communication process is very complex. You can see that so many girls are working together. One girl is standing and guiding them, giving them some instructions. So sometimes she gives instructions, sometimes they talk to each other, sometimes they may not be talking but doing some activity. On the basis of some activity of one girl, the other girl may be proceeding. In so many manner, the communication is going on, and finally, it's very difficult to find out who initiated which communication, which message was imparted, who was the receiver of the message, what was the medium, what are the channels. In social media, in social environment, in Web 2.0 tools, Web 3.0 tools, this communication is getting more and more complex. It's very difficult to plan or design a linear communication. Communication is transactional. What we mean by that? It's a transaction of message between sender to receiver and again from receiver to sender via feedback. There are some channels involved in transaction of these messages. You can see it in the classroom situation or where some audience is listening to the speaker, that is the information source. It is also shown in the graphical representation. The same way, communication is continuous. When we start communication, it passes from sender to receiver. It continues through feedback. Then again it is initiated. Then slowly sender becomes receiver, receiver becomes sender, then everybody becomes sender and everybody becomes receiver. And the process goes on and goes on. This is how communication is continuous. See this situation. Teacher is scolding the child. Now, even if teacher feels afterwards that the child was not guilty, she cannot take her words back. The message travels from sender to receiver like an arrow which cannot come back. You cannot reverse back the communication process. It's irreversible, and that's why we need to keep this characteristic always in mind. We need to be very careful while communicating because we cannot undo the communication after it takes place. Since communication is a human process, we cannot draw fixed boundaries to communication. We cannot say that communication happened exactly at this point, ended at this point, and within this frame of boundaries. And if we talk about social networking systems, then these boundaries are dissolved completely. Even though we try to set boundaries of walls of context, so far we were trying to say that the communication happened only inside classroom. But now we even cannot say that because so many learners are linked to each other, networked to each other. Teachers are communicating with each other. Teachers are communicating with distance learners. And learners are communicating with each other beyond boundaries of region, culture, even language. We can now say that yes, certainly communication process does not have fixed boundaries. Communication is unrepeatable. The way it is irreversible, it is also unrepeatable. Once a particular communication takes place in one form, in one manner, we cannot repeat the communication exactly in the same manner again. As teachers, we always experience that though we are teaching the same content next year also, or maybe during the same year to different divisions, our communication process is different. The teachers also may have some content already written in their book, but still the communication changes. You cannot repeat any communication exactly in the same manner. The receivers may be different, the form of message changes, the context changes, environment changes. Some activity may be conducted on some learners in the morning, and even if we wish to repeat that activity as it is in the other class, maybe that is after lunch, learners may or may not be responsive in the same manner. So, communication is unrepeatable. Every communication has some direction. You can clearly see that the communication, the message is traveling from the birdie to the teddy. So, receiver is listening to the message. Receiver is the person who receives message. Understanding message is their responsibility.